It's over. It's all over. My wife and daughter certainly aren't coming home anytime soon. There's nothing left for me anymore.
Hey, sir!
Who are you?
You don't want to do anything rash. Please!
What?
I know things seem as bad as they can get right now, but I'm sure they'll get better if you just give them a chance.
What do you know? You're just a kid.
I don't know a whole lot. I really don't. But I do know that you have to keep on living.
Okay. Say I do. Are you gonna take on all my debts?
Well...
That's what I thought. I'm just a waste of space and money. Nothing left to do but die.
But you can't die. Please don't do this. I'm begging you.
I just wish I could have seen my wife and daughter one last time. I don't even know where they are.
Keiko Hahabu, age 46. Works as a grocery store clerk.
Huh?
Sayaka Hahabu, age 17, 11th grader in high school, and a member of the Tea Ceremony Club.
Yamato! Mippity!
And right now you can find them both at the Grand Palace Hotel in Ochanomizu.
Really?
If you truly wish to see them so badly, you now have the information you need to do so.
Keiko! Sayaka, wait for me. I'm coming to see you both right now.
What are you all doing here?
We're here to put things right. He'll see his family and his thoughts of suicide will fade away.
Was hell tracking him down, though.
But still, it was also super duper fun. Like we were detectives or something.
You're paying the hotel fees, though.
Oh, and don't worry about the next loop. From tomorrow on, I intend to email him the location of his wife and daughter. I don't care if I have to change my routine. It's still much too disturbing to have that play out each time around.
It never even dawned on me. You guys were all out there fighting for this man's life while I was just trying to run away from reality.
Honestly, that's all I was doing too.
Yeah, same here, I guess.
Not me.
Asahi, you can't keep blaming yourself for this. Come now, back to my place. We'll celebrate our prodigal Asahi's return to the fold.
My return?
The return of our acting leader.
Your treat, Tachibana.
From now on, you're forbidden from distancing yourself from us by any more than 50 meters.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, everyone.
It's all right. I understand.
Me too. No big.
I'm so tired of hearing that.
So, shall we be off then?
Let's go.
Oh!
What is it?
Sorry, but you all go ahead. I'll meet you there. I just have somebody I need to thank first.
Hey, Tachibana!
Arasahi's clearly back to his old self. Feisty as ever, too.
I wanted to thank you.
Oh, so things went smoothly then?
Sure did. Your advice was spot on. Thank you so much.
Impressive. But you're the lifesaver. I'm glad I waited for you.
Hold up. Why were you waiting for me?
Well, maybe not waiting specifically. It's more like I was sitting here, wondering how things had turned out. But every time I had any doubt, I thought to myself, This is Asahi we're talking about. He'll do fine. I know I didn't tell you I'd be waiting for you here or anything. But let's just say, I'm glad you're here to see me.
Well, it only seemed polite.
I believe I told you before that if today just keeps repeating, we'll never be able to make a promise for tomorrow. And that would suck.
A promise for tomorrow. Well, that was quick. 2 o'clock by the Foss map on Main Street. Go to bed now so you don't oversleep. I'm not your mother, he says. What am I, a grade schooler the night before a field trip or something? Come on. That's right. This is exactly where I said I'd meet Misaki. If only I'd actually kept my word and shown up when I was supposed to.
Something wrong?
Oh, sorry. My mind was just elsewhere for a second.
You look straight up haunted. Although if you ask me, I'd say you're still a little young for that.
I don't know if I'm haunted, really. Just...
Well, whatever it is, just spit it out. I'm happy to lend an ear to your grievances. Consider it a bonus, thank you.
Come now, youngster! Throw whatever you've got at me! These old bones can take it and stay standing!
I don't think... That's...
What, have you been fighting with a friend, perhaps?
Huh? How did you know?
Ha ha ha! A woman has her ways.
That's not an answer to my question.
So, what is it you're fighting about?
Honestly, I don't even know.
Makes sense. You're the kind of guy who wouldn't even know when he didn't know something.
I don't even know where to begin with that.
It's just a joke. Or is it? Who knows? One can never truly know what's in another's heart.
Well, you're a shining example of that.
So, you might as well just throw your hands up in defeat.
Aren't you supposed to be helping me?
Sorry. It is important to try to understand what the other person is feeling, sure. Even if you don't feel it yourself. But that alone won't get you anywhere.
So, what can I do?
You need to look inside yourself. And make sure you've come to grips with your own feelings as well.
Do I not already have a grip on those?
I'm talking about the feelings you hold deep within yourself. And that can get pretty scary. You'll have to come face to face with parts of yourself you might not like. Hateful parts. Or embarrassing parts. Strip your partner bare. And strip yourself bare as well. Just let it all hang out.
What the?
Having dirty thoughts already, are you? Interesting.
No, I didn't. And this is a dude we're talking about anyway.
Well, if it's two guys fighting, that's simple then. You just get all naked.
Again with the nakedness?
You get all naked, and then you duke it out. Duke it out until you can both see eye to eye.
Duke it out? Not try to make up?
That's right. Fight till you're all fought out. If you make up with one another before you're on the same page, then you haven't really made up at all. You two just have to take it all off and smash against each other until you're totally simpatico. And once you're seeing things from each other's perspectives, you'll be friends to the end, guaranteed. Then you can meet up on the riverbank in the glow of dusk and be all like, "Wanna dance, punk? No, do you?"
What the heck?
Boys have it made. You just fist fight a little, then plop down on the grass and talk about what girls you like.
I think you put a little too much thought into this, but thanks. I actually kind of get what you're saying.
So I was able to help you out a little?
In a weird way, yeah. You were.
Then my work here is done. I'd say it's about time I head home and get wasted.
Don't drink too much now.
Oh, I will. See you around, Asahi.
I think I'll do just as she suggested and try smashing myself right into him.
Sorry to be tardy today.